will greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Again more, again this morning of Sunday, we would like to greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And then we are looking a few things here. And
now I believe it's been a long time not seeing each other. But today we just speak a little bit. We say, may the Lord bless you. Other time we spoke here. Trying to show you that he's the Son.
Amen.
Amen.
For give him a welcome kiss.
Because he once told Simeon that since I came into your place, you never kissed me. But this ill-famed woman, she never stopped kissing my feet and to wash my feet with his tears, with her tears.
And then
and to kiss my feet. Now today I want us to speak about something here. They said there were men which were called for a wedding. So they found themselves not worthy. So their conduct, was showing that they don't have the worthiness. Now the matter of God, it needs someone which is called for to pray for the Lord,
to worship,
or to worship the Lord. So he must show himself that he is worthy of these things.
We
must not find when God giving the matters. And those people who they are saying they are of this God doesn't want to show that this thing is fit for them.
And then
now that's what we are going to try to speak about it.
And then is your life worthy of the gospel?
But now look at your family now.
Is for a few minutes we will talk about that, and then we must look at our time and few other things that pertain to our time. We will still go further in other things so long as time allows. But today, let us basically put this, let us look at the worthiness. Now let us look at how God has been doing this. And I wish that the people will understand, more especially this message that has been given to us. This message that has been given to us. So we'll read in the book of Luke chapter 14. I will not follow much of the other things, but I will try to look at this. And then from verse 16 until about verse 23. Then said he unto him, a certain man made a great supper and bade many.
Jesu are motho e mongwe o be a dirile selalelo se segolo a laletsa ba bantši.
And sent his servant at supper time to say to them that were bidden, come, for all things are now ready.
Ka lebaka la go lalela a roma mohlanka wa gagwe a re a yo bitsa balalediwa a re tlang gobane dilo di lokile.
And they all with one consent began to make excuse. The first said unto him, I have bought a piece of ground, and I must needs go and see it. I pray thee, have me excused.
Ba latola ka moka ka o tee wa pele a re ke rekile tshimo me ke swanetse o yo e bona ke a go ke a rapela o go mpolelele o re ga kitle.
Another said, I bought 5 yoke of oxen and I go to prove them. I pray thee, have me excused.
E mongwe a re ke rekile pholo tsa yoko tse hlano mme ke yo ke ya go di leka ke ya go rapela o kompolelele o re ga ketle.
And another said, I have married a wife and therefore I cannot come.
E mongwe a re ke nyetse mosadi ke sona se se ntšhitišago go tla.
So that servant came and showed his lord these things. Then the master of the house, being angry, said to his servant, go out quickly into the street and lanes of the city and bring hither the poor and the maimed and the halt and the blind.
Mohlanka yeo a bua a di botsa mongwa gagwe mongwa wa ngwako a befelwa a roma mohlanka wa gagwe a re a gofa o tswele mekgotheng le mapatelong a motse o bue fa o na le badidi le digole le dihlotsa le difofu.
And the servant said, Lord, it is done as thou hast commanded, and yet there is room.
Mohlanka a tla a re mrena go dirilwe ka moo o laetsego ka gona fela go sana le sebaka.
And the Lord said unto the servant, go out into the highways and hedges and compel all them to come in, that my house may be filled.
Marena are tswela kua ditseleng le dikgoreng o ba phegelele gore ba tsene ngwako wa ka o tle o tlale.
For I say unto you that none of those men which were bidden shall taste of my supper.
Gomme ke a leboja le yo tee wa banna bala ba ba bego ba laleditswe a ka seke a leka selalelo saka.
So we will just bow our heads for a moment.
Jalo re tlo kunamiša ditlhogo tsa rena metsosonyana
and commit this whole issue to the Lord.
Re tšee taba e ka moka re fe moreno.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this period.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
We glorify you and honor you.
That's true.
We invite you that you may come in this hour, that we may see your hand moving among us. We are ordinary mortals and there's none that can do better.
Yes, Lord.
But your presence meaneth more to us. Bless the reading of the word. Speak thou to our hearts. Everywhere this message will be ministered.
Yes, Lord.
May human hearts be touched.
Hallelujah.
Bless us together as I have come here with my brother. In this room, many times Father God has stood men who came to sacrifice before you.
Yes.
And thou hast blessed them and showed mercy, and we were blessed.
Yes.
Today we are more than unworthy. We say, Lord God Almighty, the message you presented to us is such a great issue. And may you come, Lord, and show for what purpose are we where we are.
Yes, ma'am.
All this we speak believing in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So, saints, today we just want to put things in perspective. Now may men and women understand this and know that God is a reason that he has given us these things. And these things were not given to us by mistake. May God bless you. And then I've forgotten one book here. Our last brother to give me in his form. Is your life worthy of the gospel? And then look for it in there. In the phone. And then, so if it is there. Okay, normally we read about it. And then I was listening to a brother. One brother of my age. He was going to church. And he was going to preach like me. He left his book home. And the Bibles and all those things. When it was time to preach, he had none to use. I think now I'm following in his footsteps. But I'm going to say, let us not worry, because we are just giving a portion that the saints may know. Why are we in condition that we are in? And the main thing that we wish men and women can realize is that we are in this crisis nationally and internationally, which God has known that it will be here. And normally, when there is time for certain things to be fulfilled, God sent certain crisis or allow certain crisis to come so that his will be fulfilled. And then I was talking to a brother yesterday. I said to him, they tell us that the ducks were in their duck pens. The ducks.
They were in the duck pens. So they could not meet. Because each and every duck was closed in its cage.
A big storm.
So the storm came.
Then when the water was flooding, and then it was rising up to the level where it went above the pens, and then those ducks were able now to fellowship, because Now they were swimming above their barriers.
Kaobanjolo aba khona go ntela ka mogodimo ga mayago ya
ona. Now brethren, today and now in our time,
le khono le nako ye rena ye,
there's no one who received them. Where were you? Why didn't you come to church?
A hono wa ka busha mo rena go le ka gore mo sa tle kerekeng.
They listen to every pastor on every a medium of listening. They now are fellowshipping above the
darkbench.
May God help us. But during this trial, let us be focused. Because here we are looking at men and people that decided that they will not be worthy.
Bailor bai ke ruru ba ka sebe ba maloka.
God is called.
Mudimu u bidiche.
And then we know, if we can read in the book of Matthew
22,
it is said that many are called but few are chosen. Now here we find that the people were beaten to come to the wedding. And then there was a servant which was going to call them. And they were supposed to come at that time to the wedding, because they were bidden to come. But they behaved and proved themselves unworthy. We believe that people must prove their worth, that they are worthy to continue with him. They are worthy to serve him. And then meaning that we must have the right behavioral pattern and be able to listen. May God help us. Now we know that God has been doing things and then to show people what his desires are. But I just want to refer to the book of Daniel chapter 2, because he has never left us without something to show us that we can see what his desires are. Now in the book of Daniel, and then we find that Nebuchadnezzar, he dreamed a dream. And then we know about all that.
We
can read Daniel chapter 1.
He said
Nebuchadnezzar, he had a dream. Then we know what that dream was about. The different kingdoms were coming in. Now I want us just to be careful in listening, so that we can see why things are the way they are. And in the second year of the reign of Nebuchadnezzar, dreamed dreams wherewith his spirit was troubled, and his sleep break forth, a break from him. Daniel chapter 2.
Chapter 2, verse 1.
Nebuchadnezzar,
kangwaga wa bobedi wa mmusho wa gagwe, o kile a lora diloro, pelo ya gagwe ya tshoga, a felela ke boroko.
Alright, here is the dream.
It
has been dreamed by the king of that time. Now we know it ends up in iron, which is the hardest of all that material.
Now there's
one thing which I want to show you.
There's
one Brother Branham speaks about
it.
Because here we are having a servant. He sent to beat those who have been invited to come. Then to say to them, it is time. Come, it is supper time. But they were found unworthy. Now, today we are seeing a temptation that has fallen upon all the earth. I can say this plague is not the beating part of the earth, it's the whole earth. Now Nebuchadnezzar's dream was speaking about the whole earth. Now I want to give it to you in this manner. In the book, What Shall I Do with Jesus Called the Christ? It will be paragraph 44. Brother Branham, in part of it, he says he was sowing a seed. He was sowing, planting. God was sowing a seed for the nations to watch. Nations. Amen.
Amen.
Dilibelele. And each time that when that kingdom was issued in, it had to do according to what that word said. So partly because the nations were to watch.
To watch what?
When that wait come to pass. And in actual fact, it is written for us in the Bible. For us to watch. When that which has been spoken comes to pass.
Amen.
Amen. When they come to pass. Amen.
Amen.
So for that very reason, exactly as the nations were to watch, now we also, we are given the way to watch. And we know that when those ways of the prophets and were fulfilled, prophets were fulfilled, and then they were exactly according to those prophecies. Amen.
Amen.
The fulfillment were according to what those prophecies
said.
Are we together?
More.
Now we say, when the Messiah came, he had to answer those words of God that was to be fulfilled. Pertaining to him. And then we also are to answer those words that spoke of us. And nations They had what they were supposed to watch. Pertaining to their times. Amen.
Amen.
And now also us. We are watching according to what things were to come in our time. This really, may God help us. Amen.
Amen.
Now here we find that God send a servant. If we go into the book of Matthew 22, there were servants. They were bidding people to come. But in Luke here we find that there was a servant. Now we know all along it has been the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost was going all over, moving those 17, all those fears.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So that people may not give an excuse.
Alright,
let's think a bit about this. The prophet tells us
that
God will never call a man to judgment unless he gives him a warning. So it is said to be a warning and then judgment. And then for that very reason, that is how things were made known. Amen.
Amen.
People were given a warning.
But what filled the water?
Adam and Eve in the garden.
Adam and Eva
they were told that they stole from eating. And then if you do it, according to the word, you'll be punished. And then they were not supposed to eat from that tree. And then but we know men always doesn't take it. When God gives the word, they don't take care of that. They normally would give an excuse for failing to do what God told them to do.
Hallelujah. Amen.
But I want us to look at this very well. May God give us grace.
And
I believe we'll be given in this time to see what these things is about. I hope everything is going well here. Amen.
Amen.
So God having given a warning, it will always be according to his word. He will not fail to do it directly according to the word. What he had spoken, he will do. So he cannot warn the individuals and not warn the church. He cannot warn the church without warning the nation. Because when he goes from among people, he reaches out to all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who would remember the message that Brother Branham was given was to go to all in the whole world. Even to the kings. Now you remember when Davis was arguing with Brother Branham.
Davis,
his pastor, he said, "Who are you? You are uneducated. How will you even go to the king? Such like things.
That's what
and then you come where you think somebody is not a worthy person to do that.
But
imagine somehow to do with King George in England.
yako England bari ko
ku chijo. That was the biggest nation on earth at that given time.
La tsori yela yiyo yaba nako enwe khulu ile ya
tuwa. The biggest nation.
Oh si chaba si sungu.
It was the biggest nation on earth.
England ibe le na ha e khulu.
And then their king was held.
Khoshi ya bona ile ya fola.
And then we have got we call congressman Upshaw.
Rena lo mo bona lo congressman Upshaw.
A man that has been sick for 66 something years.
Bona o
About 68
years on a wheelchair.
Was delivered from that ailment.
A fall among which
my God
come on,
was speaking to nations through the leadership in political
circle.
That here there's a visitation. And then the whole world over. You know when Brabham was in Durban. There was a queen in Rhodesia.
And
that was a queen then. She came to the meetings. And then you know this message. It has not only been spoken in corners. No, it has spoken even in rulership corridors.
The
corridors of governance. So, the leaders of the world knew about this. Amen.
Amen.
Exactly as we heard the Caiaphas and then all those big men of the days of
Jesus Christ,
they knew about his presence. The world has known about the presence of his message through all of it. But remember, we are living in the closing of history. But I want to show you there is a danger. If God gives the word and the people reject it, is very dangerous. Are we together?
Are more?
Or let me read something.
Oh, I can see
Amen.
Amen.
You know, God never fails. When the word has been spoken for this certain generation, there is going to be somebody rise on the scene. And that will fulfill that word. I believe it is courage. So that's why Jesus in his day he qualified, he fulfilled every word that spoke about his messiahship.
Amen.
Amen. God has spoken it. It is a vindication of the spoken word. That's why Jesus met every qualification and was the way vindicated as Messiah. You see, there is also words spoken in the Bible for the last days. Those words have to come to life.
Manchu au asante atle mo bophelo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now those ways has to come to life.
Manchu au asante atle mo bophelo.
Now here we are listening to Jesus.
Galo far challenge Jesus.
And then we can read other scriptures.
Re ka khona go le mangolo a mangwe
and show that Jesus being the fulfillment of the word of his day. The Jewish nation rejected him. He knew they were going to reject
him.
Now here we are told these people, when they were rejecting him, they were refusing to come to the Sapa.
Bakana otamo dijon jaman tibu.
The wedding supper was prepared for the son. And the people were refusing to be part of that wedding. They rejected to come to that wedding. Now let us look at how they counted themselves unworthy. And then even today, people are doing the same thing.
But
the word of God is there. When it is being presented to them, say to them, this is the way to the wedding
supper.
One has his own church. One has got his another problem. The others are in the message. When they must kneel down and pray, they are tired. They give excuses. They don't have time with God. They are refusing to this supper time. But he has never stopped calling people to this supper time. He is still calling people to this supper time. May God help us. And then we will take our time to read this thing. Now you can go in the book of Matthew
27.
I will just refer it to you. So you read from verse 11. It was Jesus, which was the way before the governor. Today, the word is brought to trial by the nations of the world. But there's a reason why. We need to panic. No, we know there's no trial that can be above our capacity. God has already given us, capacitated us to overcome. We have power within ourselves. Because from the beginning, every seed was given power within itself to produce itself. So we have got nothing to worry. No, let us realize, friend, because we are more than conquerors. Here was Jesus before Pilate. After the word has been rejected and all that, you can keep on reading chapter 27, and then you will see what transpired. Now in the courts.
Oh, modi tupuleng.
And then we are going to continue reading. What shall I do with Jesus?
And
we find here that when in the days of our Lord, the church had already rejected him before he came to Pilate's judgment.
Now,
listen carefully. The church rejected him before he came to Pilate's judgment. They had turned him down from the very first day that his ministry started to prophesy, telling them a truth about the way. Then they could not understand that. How that him being a man could know what was in the people's hearts. And the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4, the word of God is so powerful, it even discerns the hearts. Amen.
Amen.
Now they couldn't believe it. And they rejected him. Now here there is something that always goes with the manifestation of
God.
When the people reject the word that is being made manifest, in that time, they are the elect all the same in that time. And the elect will be the ones that will see. May God help us. So for that very reason, now let me read a statement. Always, just the elected is the only things that will see it. Because it is elected and ordained to see it. Now, even in these rejections of all previous times, the elect of that day, they saw it. Can you imagine how holy was the priest? And all the priests, they were holy men.
Who
according to the laws, they were checked even their bodies. They had to be a perfect human. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But yet, the same people that were so fitting for the ministry at that time, they rejected Christ, they refused to believe him, but they were a minority. There were a minority.
There
was a minority that saw it. But the rest of the nation of
Israel,
they saw nothing. Now let us think very simple. If you were living in Egypt, let's say you were a general. If you were a general of the army, and then if you were not, somewhere very close to
Pharaoh,
and you heard there's a man with a stick that has been threatening Pharaoh,
really
you were not going to believe
that
such an entity can bring the kingdom of Pharaoh to
out.
Because the kingdom of Pharaoh was vast
and it was big.
And it was big. But
Moses
was their prophet
and
their God.
And
because God told him, when you get there,
you'll
be a God to Pharaoh. So when Pharaoh was rejecting, Moses, he was not aware that the kingdom of that nation is coming to
naught.
Do you know that the world is not aware that by rejecting the message that William Marion Branham preached, a poor and an educated person, and then I want to say this, do you know the world doesn't realize that by refusing such a humble, simple human person in a scientifically advanced world, the churches,
the Greek,
the world,
the fast
nations,
the
you know, you must know Branham was a prophet to the nations.
eleng profeta wa
setšhaba.
Just
exactly like that Moses was going to take the rest of Egypt into the sea.
Le farao o ile re o ba setse boreng egapeta e be išwa mo
Moses.
Moses
was bringing the kingdom of Pharaoh.
O ba tlisa mmušo wa farao
into ruins.
Go tlisa fatshe.
O shwalala.
Go ba go shwalanya.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then that kingdom
yalo mmušo o
was going to be destroyed.
O ile o boile go tsenywa.
And then the world is like
le fase le jwa
is like it is very unlikely.
Ba bona ka re
that the words of William Marion Branham can bring this world to an end. Friends, this is what we are coming to. Exactly what is going to happen through the words of that man. Our world is coming
to.
May God help us. So I hope people will be able to understand
how far we are.
And then, so
Jesus
had come to pronounce deliverance to humanity. Through him, salvation was to come to man. And the Bible says,
in the Bible,
he was the sacrifice, the Lamb of God that carried away the sin of the world.
So
if he carried the sin of the world, that message must go to the whole world. Now let us look at it.
Because
I think the kingdom of
Pharaoh
came down under Moses and was destroyed under Moses.
Was destroyed.
Are we together?
Amen.
Now all other kingdoms has been coming to ruins. Because of prophetically rejecting what the prophet spoke to them. And then let us look at Luke chapter 4. And then we are going to see something here. Just for a few minutes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, but before we read,
we'll foul,
and then the Luke chapter 4, let me read this quote. Isn't it that I told you the elect to see it? I said the elect.
Oh, Amen.
Paragraph 92,
paragraph 92,
page 14 of What Shall I Do When Jesus Called the Christ?
Page 14, you're not telling that Jesus was John Christ.
Now you look at the worthy and the unworthy. I'm only asking the question.
Is
your life worthy or the cost? Then when Jesus came as the anointed,
and
done just exactly what the word of God said he would do. And yet the Jews were looking for something else. A king come in with a rod of iron in his hand. But this is way in the future. But he fulfilled every word. There one day in
Capernaum,
when he picked up the scripture and read, Did you notice?
Na le lemuri.
He just read part of the scripture.
Runuba la karolo fela le ngwa.
Then he laid the book down.
Abia buka ile fast.
And said,
Are
today this is fulfilled.
Kono le ngwalo le lephetshage.
That is in the book of Luke chapter 4.
Ke mo buku ya Luke wa bone.
Where I want to read with you.
Mo ke nyaka re bale ka moka.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, in the
Isaiah,
in Isaiah 61,
he
spoke about the Jubilee.
Now,
the year of Jubilee, but here, we will read how far he read. They gave him the book. And then he read this paragraph.
Voilà, c'est tout pour l'assé.
Now you must know when Brother Abraham was preaching judgment in our day about the birth pains.
Or comme le chubrenem avait avoir raka katlolo ya na go ya rena mo bukunya di tlhabikapelego.
And then they gave him the book.
Ba mo file book.
Here they gave Jesus the book.
Fa ba file Jesus book.
And there they gave Brother Brenham.
Le fa ba file mo chubrenem book.
I think we can see and we can understand.
Ya mo re gona go bona le go kushi.
Why he was going to do exactly as Jesus did.
Gore uba o santse o dira ka mogho Jesus a dirileng ka gona.
He was going to pronounce what is the purpose of the word in our generation. The invitation has been rejected. Is always few that are called the elect that will receive that
word.
Now I believe with us it is happening the same way.
Okay.
Verse 18 he says and then excuse me, I just want us to read in short. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has appointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captive and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised.
Moya wa morena o na le nna ka gobane o mpietse go begela babotlana taba tse di botse, o nthumile go alafa ba dipelo tse di robegilego, ba ba thupilwego ke ba rwelele kgonologo, ba difofu ke re ba buše ba bone, ba ba dubaganego ke re ba ikele ba olotswe, ke bege ngwaga wa kgatlhego wa morena.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord, that is the Jubilee. Amen.
Amen.
And then in the Jubilee year, everyone was taken, had a right to go back to his property.
And
has a right to go free.
And I
want to believe that when Jesus came, he was to restore us to our humanity. What Adam lost,
and
then was coming back
to
Christ. Now I want us to look at this. Now when he has read this, he cut the book. He cut the verse in half.
Verse
and then he said, when you hear this word, they are fulfilled in your ears. Now, when Brother Branham was preaching in the message of birth pains, he was given a book. Afterwards, the Spirit of God came to him to show him why It has to be dramatic.
Because
the servant was to give Christ a book.
Today
the servant was to give Branham a
book.
Because he was going to pronounce something.
Now I want you to listen
here. And then I'm in Isaiah chapter 61.
Now, Isaiah 61.
Saints, I'm just going to lay this in perspective. I hope they don't close our electricity with load shedding.
If they
close it, don't worry, that will be the end of my message.
I will
call the fool, come back.
We will
continue right there where the load shedding stops us. But if they don't shed off load, and then we will continue. I believe you hear what this is about. May God give us grace. Now, Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. And you know, Jesus stopped here.
That's all just what we mean.
The acceptable year of the Lord. Here he stopped. And the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all the nations, to comfort all that man.
Lele chachi latifecho ya modimo wa rena gore go hunu go motse botle ba banyamilwe.
Now the message of Brother Branham is fulfilling this part. Now the only problem that angers the people,
what thata fela bo bokwati shambatho,
is that this man is fulfilling a portion of the scripture. They fail to see that we that have believed that message, we are part of the fulfillment of that. In actual fact, the continuance of the day of vengeance of our God is in our hands. We are the people actually that is proclaiming to our world. We are saying to this world, you refuse to humble yourself to this word, you are calling judgment upon yourself. That time, judgment went upon Christ. That time, judgment went upon Christ. Because of us all. But today, it is going to be judgment upon all the earth because of rejecting that message. Then the fact that a proclamation for that vengeance and has been proclaimed by William Marion Branham does not stop with him, because the same message is continuing. The people that has believed that
are
still proclaiming, and the world continues to reject. But now let me show you the rejection. And then what brought us to culminate into the World Council of Churches, come to the World Council of Churches. World Council of Churches. Is the rejection of the way from
Pentecost.
But we can prove that. And then we'll settle to know how we came. But let me read this. Amen.
Amen.
Now Jesus stood there. When he was to preach the year of Jubilee. Why didn't he read the rest of it? Because it pertains to his other coming. Are we there? I hope we will understand. May God give us grace. Amen.
Amen.
This part of the scripture pertaineth to his other coming. They had no need of knowing that. That is for the age when he will come in. But the age that he was in, that is the reason he could say this scripture is fulfilled today in your eye. Right here you see it, to preach the acceptable season and bind up the broken hearted and heal the sick. That is what he came for. The rest of it was to bring judgment to the Gentiles and so forth. So that comes next. See, the Gentile has to reject him.
First.
Now we are going to look on how the Gentiles rejected it.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You know, we have few other things to show here. But we'll keep on bringing more of these things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the Holy Ghost here in our reading is the servant that is being sent, and then he goes all over and then he is bringing for that the bidding that they should come to the wedding supper. But did they accept?
Now,
in all the time that the Holy Ghost has presented this issue, only the elect received. And may the Lord give us grace that in our time we will not fail. Because as we have read here, the Gentiles had to reject him first. But now for us, we must be able to see how he went to the Gentiles. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then because according to the Bible, at the crucifixion, where we have read in Matthew, where we have pointed in Matthew 27, God's word has been thoroughly vindicated. It had been proven over and over that it was the answer to God's word. Because that the scribes, they have read about him, but they had their tradition formulated out of that. Now, it made it difficult for them to receive what God was doing, because they, out of that way, they produced a tradition and a creed. But
dithuto tsa bona.
But it was already laid there in the Old Testament.
O be se tlhile fa mo Testamenteng.
Okay, even now today.
Le khono.
The word
lintu
is laid out.
Le beilwe.
Is there in the Bible?
Le khono mo Bibeleng.
Even when Brother Abraham was doing this.
Le ge mo Shebrema wa dira se.
If people had gone back to the Bible.
But bo re ba ka ba boetse mo ra go Bibeleng.
And not to the tradition.
E seng gore ba mo mitlwaeng ya bona.
They would have seen that.
Ba ba ka ba bone.
This man is speaking the way.
Or munna o bolela leng.
And this is true.
And it say, you're not here.
Could they see?
Na ga ba ba ka bona.
No, they have the traditions to look.
Ba ka se bone ka bona ba le le mitlwa yo sa ba lebelle mo go.
They look in those things.
Ba lebelle mo di.
It can happen from that.
Ba na na re ka dira out mo seo.
But I want to say again.
U be ka rata go bolela gape ke.
God has already got it laid out.
Modimo le modimo o itsere a ebe.
O le beyang.
O le beya kan.
They let the ministry study it, but you see, they take somebody else's word about it. Somebody's word. Instead of the word of God. So the Bible in Isaiah.
No, Bible in Isaiah
said Israel would be blind.
Israel, it will fulfill.
Amen.
Amen.
The fufala.
Oh, itlo fufala.
Would be blind.
Itlo fufala.
And they were blind.
And ba fufeng.
Now today in the book of Revelation chapter 3.
Yo lo mo tlhamo puku ya kutulo wa boraro.
The church is said to be blind.
Kereke e be itse gore e fufala.
And then it is blind.
Ka nnete fufeng.
They are refusing this invitation.
Ba gana memo ye.
But we'll show it how it was rejected among the Gentiles.
Because
God doesn't bring people to judgment without warning them. We see today the symptom of judgment. But it is not yet fully understandable.
But
we want to say to you, with the world that doesn't seem to understand what is happening. Friends, it is something that God has spoken that it would come. So let us look into the word and see, because a sin word rejecting generation of men and women. A sinful generation.
Oh, muluku, oh, bubi, oh, gana linchu la mudi.
Word rejecting.
Oh, gana linchu.
Is receiving these conditions.
Oh, amurela maemwa.
Because it has been gradually coming.
Kama na kanya na kanya lubuwe, cha.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right. God is just. That's paragraph. Where am I now?
Nakmuka.
Oh, I said 92 instead of 52. That
okay, really paragraph 92. Now, Sandiker paragraph 52.
And then I'm sorry.
Lensorele.
And now I'm on 55.
The like more paragraph 55.
They were so blinded to the truth. That when the truth is presented, they fail to see. But you see, God is just.
He has
got it wrote out there.
He
has got it wrote out there. He has got it wrote out right here. In the book, what is going to happen today? Are we together? You remember John when he was speaking about the excess laid and the root of the tree. And then because God is expecting fruit. And every tree that does not bring forth
fruit
will be taken out of the vineyard. It would won't be there. It
will
no more be there. And let me remind you. When you read in Matthew chapter 22, those servants, he treated his servants. His servants. Some of them, they gave excuses, went to their
things.
Some remained and ill treated God's servants.
Servants, God's servants.
They beat them. And some of them they killed.
Now the
master.
When
he comes.
Raita.
The Bible says.
Bibili.
He will punish those servants.
Because
they found not worthy for his supper. He will bind them, punish them, and burn their city. Now here we are coming into those things. Now we are rolling into that final stage where the punishment is about to fully
complete.
But before that, these things are made more clear. They are becoming more understandable. Amen.
Amen.
So they won't be there any longer. Amen.
Amen.
And John said,
and John Ari,
and then that tree. That is without fruit will be rooted out. It will not be part of the garden. Are we together? Now I believe. Now the traditions has made things difficult for people to accept God. Our God is just. Now, when in 325
AD,
after Christ,
oh, Kamrava Christ, sorry, Kamrava Lukula Christ,
the Roman
Baroma
made what we call a Catholic Church.
Catholic.
According to its way, is universal. And then they just wanted to put everything under the system. Now, did you know what the denomination did? And the sorry state of affair.
Sorry state of affair.
They did it before Brother Branham, just in the presence of a messenger. And then the very man that is coming to beat them. To invite them.
Oh,
to
come.
Has been sent to say to the guy, come. They say, okay, they forget about him. They say, no, let's make a World Council of Churches. Now they bait it in front of that man. Whether he's looking or not, he had to see
it,
that we want to come. They made World Council of Churches and they made it in America.
Why did you go to America?
All right, we will relax. Sorry. Now I've realized I'm becoming a little bit old. Then I can talk as an old man. Be patient with me. I'm not young again. I used not to realize that I'm as old as I am.
And then
so generally 2 years ago qualify Lemoten. Bale RC Lichanemu.
Now let's listen to one another, yeah?
You know in the book of Revelation there are beasts.
La tsa mo pugunya ya kutulu gona le di diwata.
And then the other one is from the sea.
Sebata se mo tswa go lewatleng.
And the other one it was from the land.
Se se mo tswa mo lefase.
Now it is very much shocking.
How would ya chush?
If I can just maybe I just refer you to Revelation 13, but read the prophet. Now he speaks about Christ being on trial. And then so he says, we are standing today in another Pilate's judgment hall. Now, can you imagine that? If there is a Pilate's hall, who's to be judged? Let's look. Many people they when they read about the deeds of those Pharisees,
but ba bantse ba bala ka dipiro tsa ba Pharisee,
and those elders that were there,
le ba go lo ba 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 le gona fao,
they can easily say, I wouldn't have allowed this.
Ba ka no re mo bonolo ba ra nna nka se dumele taba e.
But today,
yeah,
we are in the judgment hall of
Pilate. Now he is
tried today. That is paragraph 82. Or that other one is paragraph 8.
Yeah,
then
paragraph
go
eight.
Down from there. Now he is tried today. Just has been tried and on trial for the world system to be formed of what is called the Council of Churches. To form in the World Council of Churches, what have they done? They voted that they will absolutely unite themselves together and have a council of churches. In this council of churches, all churches must belong to this council. If they don't, you are not even allowed to preach. You are not even allowed to have a prayer for the sick. And your church could be used for anything they want to use it. They want to store boxes in it or ammunition or whatever. No control of it at all.
You
either belong to the Council of Churches or you don't belong at all. That is the system that's being formed here in the United States.
Now,
I wanted this statement very much. That is the system that is being formed here in the United States.
It
fulfills the scripture to the
dot.
It fulfills what the Lord spoke to me in
1933.
And we are standing at that time this morning. Jesus Christ, the way
Jesus
is at trial today, as it was on the crucifixion. Now he is on our hands. He is on the hands of the world. The word has been clearly identified around the world. You remember I told you that when the ministry of Brabham starts, it went to a position where it was ministered even to the high ups, to the kings, and to the big politicians, until it was known in the corridors of power. But now, right there in the corridors of power, today they have got the blood of Jesus Christ on their hands for rejecting the way. Amen.
Amen.
And then you know how denominations stand him down.
And
I just read a statement where the priest and them, they rejected him. The priest and them, they rejected him. And then the nation, they took him to the nation. And then the government, the government rejected him. Then the church rejected him. And the government rejected him. And they crucified him. Here today, if this rejection is in the hands of the church, and also has been identified to the world, the kingdoms, the governments, they know about this. They deliberately formed a union. In that union, they used it to reject the message. Is that all right? Now I can think that is what is happening. And then the prophet, that's why he says, he is tried in the council of churches. They rejected him. He is tried now. And they rejected him. And choose rather as they did then. Now, you know, recently the Pope said, these denominations, they left him. Like Joseph. And then now they are coming because there is famine into their brother. And then now the trouble is, we find ourselves standing exactly in the same place as the Israel was standing. Now let us look what is happening. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word has been vindicated, has been made real, has been shown to be the truth. Now we are going to see how does the humanity and the nations becomes involved in the rejection of Christ.
Now, but
and this has been shown to be true. And at the last days, as Jesus said, as it was in the days of Sodom, so shall it be as at the coming of the Son. The very God himself, who was the
Word,
predicted the end time and what would happen. And the lights would break forth in the evening time. Now that Malachi 4 was send for those things and prove to them. And
just
been brought to the place of decision. And the churches has turned it down. And what have the churches done? A matter of the word. What has the churches desired? A matter of the word. One who takes a system. And if the system is contrary to the word, it is a matter of the word. And they desired a denominational tradition. And the state of the true word being manifested. And prove that it is God among the people. It is God among the people. By signs, through picture, light, the same angel of the Lord, the pillar of fire, the same one that lived on earth. In the book of Jesus Christ, he has come upon these people in the last
day.
His people, where science has took the picture of it. The church has seen it. Its works. It is thoroughly identified by tapes, everything around and around the world. Personally ministered. Still in all of that, and their system are desiring a council of churches and to condemn the truth. They desire a murderer that will shut off, stop, sell out. It will do it. They will stop such a thing, and the council of churches will have to do it. And there is the mark of the beast, Antichrist, against the word which is Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, do you know, let me just say, mention this. What do we have here? The denominations, they went out of the Catholic Church. They went out
of
the Catholic Church. And they formed their own ways of worship. They tried to walk with the way. Later on, they say, maybe the mother was right. You know, it's like daughters that are running away from their mother. Because their mothers are not doing things right. Later on, they think, maybe the mother was right. They go back to the Catholic, where the mother was at war. They are harlots. So we don't want to go into that. But I think the program of Catholicism has brought all the churches back to harlotry.
Program ya kereke Catholic ino kisha di kereke kamko wela mrao mo botsweng.
Now they are in the Council of Churches. That was formed right there in the United States. And verse 11 of chapter 13.
Verse 11 of chapter 13.
You don't need to worry. We'll come back to other things. We'll come back to the horns, names of blasphemy, many other things. We'll come to that. Amen.
Amen.
And I have I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
Kabona sebata se sengwe se rotoga lefaseng sena le dinaka tse pedi tse kego ke tsa kwana mola se bolela bokanoga.
How good God dealt with humanity. How the good God.
Amen.
Amen. He allowed the people that had desire to worship him, to settle in America. But all of a sudden they changed. Where it was the spirit of a lamb, then the language was a dragon. The Americans went there for freedom of worship. Running away from Catholicism. But all of a sudden they speak the same language with Catholicism. And listen what they did. This beast, which is America.
Say lo America.
He exercised all the power of the first beast before him.
Verse 12.
And he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and causes the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wounds was healed.
Setla sidira matla kamoka asbata sapili. Sona silveleci silveleci. Sidira gore lefase le ba baagile mo go lona ba lotshe sebata seo sa pele se se fodile go ntho ya sona e be go iša lehung.
And he does great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of all men.
Sidira mehlolo sa ba sa neša molotwa go le godimong wa wela lefaseng batho ba lebeletše.
Now you know America was the first to bring forth that hydrogen bomb.
Now,
I think it was at the meeting of the big four or big three in Potsdam. It was Stalin and it was Churchill and I don't know who was Truman or Roosevelt, that America. Then the Americans and the British.
American, British.
They knew. They were busy trying to test an atomic bomb. The Russians didn't know. Stalin was not knowing.
Stalin,
now, the language they were using between Churchill and the leader of America, they were using the language of flop and prop. Whether that thing succeeded or not. And then the American leader said it has succeeded.
Now,
they went to Japan and tested it. The world saw it, and then it was deadly. It has not come to the level of the known world then. People didn't think that it would happen like that. But it did happen. And the Bible speaks of it. Maketh fire come down from
heaven.
Verse 14. And desired, deceived them that dwelleth on the earth, by the means of those miracles which he has power to do, that is America.
Baba hile gole fasting se ba rosha ka metlo ya sona ye e dumeletswego go e dira pele ga sebata sela.
In the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to the beast which has the wound, but by a sword and did live.
sebotsa ba ba ri le fasen sere sebata seo santho ya le rumo se sebwetse go sa phela ba se betlele se swantsho.
Now you see these people making a world cancer right in front of William Branham.
La bona batho ba dirang mogatlhwa dikereke gana mo pele ga matlho William Branham.
And then now they united the Protestantism denominations.
Jolo ba thoma go bokana ba Protestant le ba di kereke tsa maina.
And then they make a World Council of Churches.
Ba dira mogatlho wa lefatshe wa dikereke.
There we see it now.
Jolo re bona ga jwale.
Are we together? Now we won't go too far. But now the World Council of Churches is confirmed. And they had power to give it life.
And
the image of the beast. That's verse 15, bro. And it had power to give the life unto the image of the beast. That the image of the beast should both speak and come that as it may, as would not wash, and cause, okay, that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
So now, if you want to, I will say, Swancho, so Sasavata, Sapil, Sisifebo Pelo, Swancho, so Sibulele, Sabe, Sikone, Wulaisha. Baba sa khunamele go se swantsho sa sebaka.
Now we are together here.
Mofa.
And he caused all both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
Se khona gore batho bohle ba banyane le ba bagolo ba khumi le ba didi ba ba khunuluke le ba hlanka ba swaiwe ka le swao sa tleng se setona le go le ge e le phatleng.
And that no man might buy or sell save the he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name.
Le gore go se be le e a gonang go reka le go rekisha ge e se eo a nago le leswao la leina la sebata le ge e le palo ya leina la sona.
Here is wisdom.
Jalo fa ke botlhale.
Now verse 18, bro. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath an understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. And his number is 666.
Mo go nyaka bohlale e ana go le hlaloganyo a tlhathe palo ya sebata gobane ke palo ya motho. Palo ya sona ke makgolo a selelago ana go le masome a selelago a metso e selelago.
Now here we arrive at this.
Jalo fa re fitlha mo go se.
But I want to go back to show how we arrived at this. For the world to arrive here is because they have rejected Christ. The invitation that has been given to bring them to the supper, they turned it down. Now we are going to go back to see the formation of Catholicism. And then I know we were further up, but we'll go back. Why? Because we must know the world for it to come here where it is. It's because of the rejection of Christ. You would say to me, what has Russia done?
Russia did really.
What have these all other nations done? It's because they rejected
Christ.
The Bible says he is a just God. And Abraham says advocate for that. And I so do say the same. God is a just God. He would not just bring the world to judgment. No, it might bring hardship to believers also. Because when Nebuchadnezzar took them out of Jerusalem. The Daniels.
Daniel.
Daniels, the Meshachs and Abednego and so on. They were included. They were righteous men. But they were taken to captivity. And now that these things are happening with us in presence, does not mean that God has forgotten that we are here. No. Let us just do that which is worthy. Let us humble ourselves. Live a clean life. According to the message. Because why? These things that has been written here. They are happening. And then it is now our time that we should look in the scriptures. In the Bible. And then in the quotes. And then see ourselves where we are. For our God is involved in this program. He knows where we are. Amen.
Amen.
If our lives, we continue in that clean life. Separate from the things of the world. Give no excuses for non-performance. And then sometimes people fail to do the right thing. And then when they fail, they give an excuse why they do not perform. But stop that. Serve God right. Surrender your life to
God.
So that you can know
he
is one that controls your life. Then what I like is he was now compelling them to come. Because it is him that furnishes the dress. And then it's him that furnishes the dress. And then he prepares us. And then we will arrive safe. Now I want us to go back and look at that Luke 14 that he sent forth a servant, and this servant we will see him in Russia, we will see him in Germany, we will see him in nations, because he's been sent out. Now how did this nation become what they are? How did the churches become what they are? Why are the individuals also joining up with the system? And then rejecting the word, turning God down. People know this word is right. But they do not want to separate with their denomination. You know, like when that blind man was given his eyes, and then his parents, they said he's of age. Ask him. Now the Bible says they did not want to confess him. Confess Christ.
Confess
him. And then because they feared to be excommunicated from the synagogue.
And
multitudes of people today, they cannot receive the message. They cannot humble themselves to the way. Because they fear to be excommunicated from churches.
The
cycle of influence. And then they want to remain in that system. For that, they will not taste his supper. They can talk about the rapture. They will not be in the rapture. May God bless us. Let's close our eyes. Close this service in prayer. God bless you.
modimo a lokileng alpha le omega wena mo ba bona mo go jwa le gona re go leboga morena re go leboga khoshi le jula ga go shile le boletsi tate o shwa mo godimong re a tseba ga matla o hlo re ke tshosha magale mabedi morena mo le fitlhang gona le a khagamolla modimo a lokileng ke sentjalo ka ramatla o tshedi di busetsa ka theko tate o shuke a dumela re le fitla le fasting ka moka ramatla o tshe ba role ba rodi ba hao the elect mo go tlo mo aleng kona morena a ke lentjula ha o ramatla o tshe mo fitlhelele mo thinthe marole morena a o ramatla o tlhaka ba khotsi ke di tlhaka tlhakano tsa le fase ramatla o tshe re a khopela ka lena le phela la mpulishi morena Jesu Kriste gore ye ma ramatla o tlo re emele Rebe ga lo rama ka o tle ka motlhanka hao yo rama ta o tle a re nge ba se no mo gumisha morena a se fele matla mongwa ha ya re boelela o e go ba di tsana ba bitse ba tle ta ba tla o tle rena ke rena ba plus fatlo sa hao lentjula hao rama ka o tle motlhanka hao ga etla re mokwile that 70 rama ka o tle ga re bitse rama ta o tle re khonne go batamela go boneng ba hao rama ta o tle rata go ba karolo ya monyanya wa hao morena re direle se aparo tate o eshu se rama ka o tle re kweleng rama ka o tle gore se ka khona rama ka o tle re re le apere di aparo tse di tshwanang ke rama ka o tle le go lentjula hao modimo a lokileng re tla khona rama ka o tle ba karolo ya monyanya wa hao ka ba mo ngwe re kwele mo bangwalong gore ge mongwe a bona yo mongwe yo se a tsena rama ka o tle ka mogwa maleba rama ka o tle re kwele rulantshiwa morena ya lentjula hao rama ka o tle re fitlhe dipelong lentjula hao le re rilo rama ka o tle re a khopela hle sho fa tsa motlhanka hao mo shumishitse modimo wa ka o khonne go tloletsa khopolo re ibone yo rama ka o tle ka phele ka rama phelo rena khotsi ya go loka a ke le fitlhelele botlhe mo go tlhe mo baleng kona le fa o rama ka o tle ba sa khone go fitlhelela dilo tse tsa tshepidiso rama ka o tle go ba tsa technology rama ka o tle ka bua diele mo kgwa kgona gore ba kgone go kwa lentjulela hao gore le gona go ba fitlhelela morena gore ba seka tle ba fitlhelela ke ka tlholo e seng ke ba fitlhelela ke tshebotso modimo wa lokileng a re rapela ke a kgopela ke re tlhe mosofatse motlhanka gao moshomise moruti wa phuthego morena molebele ka botho kgosi mo kgontšhe gore ka metlha rama ka o tla kgone go tlisa dilo tse di kgone go fitlhelela batho ka yone tsela e modimo wa ka mo batho ka moka ba tla go kgona go kwešiša le go di bona ka leina le phela la mpholosi morena Jesu Kriste ke a rapela kgosi ke re tlhe ka go lotheletsa lentjo la gao fela bao rama ka o tlhe ba kgonunu ba khunetsweng a ka ba khunuluge ba ba lwalang ba fole ba o rama ka o tlhe re kweleng rama ka o tlhe re lentjule gore go le ka Jesaya wa masometshela tee modimo wa ka gore le rometse gore re khunulule ba ba tlemilweng rama ka o tlhe ke ka baka la kgaolo ya gao modimo wa ka ge le kgono re le fa re tle le mologolile ke re tlhe a ka le tlemolele ba bangwe ba ba sa tlemilweng e ka loba le ba bangwe rama tla otlhe ba tlema ke tsa lefase modimo wa ka a ka le ba tlemolole ka leina la morena Jesu Kriste gore re kgone rama tla otlhe go fitlha mo monyanyeng wa gago ka moka rama tla otlhe ba re memilweng re filweng the invitations rama tla otlhe re seke ra e turn down modimo wa ka ka gobane re a tseba rama tla otlhe gore ge re turn the invitation down re turn wena down modimo wa lokileng jalo re gaogele ka leina le phela la mpholosi morena Jesu Kriste o re fe kgono le tsebo le tlhaloganya go kgona go tseba lentjo la gao rama tla otlhe gore ke le le re dumelelang rama tla otlhe go kgona go fitlhelela fa o rama tla otlhe the rapture rama tla otlhe ya bana ba gao ke rapela rama tla otlhe ke rapela botlhe ba tlhanka ba gao barwalo ba rredi modimo waka bana baeshu moreneng mo gotlhe mo ba leng gona ke ba gao ka ba kgopelela rama tla otlhe ke re tlhe a ke kgaolo ya gao ba fitlhelele ba kgone go lemoga le go tseba bokaone ka lone lentjule rama tla otlhe ke rapela ke leboga in Jesus Christ name we pray father thank you for your grace and for your mercy amen
amen Our lewele.
We are thankful.
Ovile mo botse ma ya lefa.
It was good to be together, saints.
And then re re morena a sho fa tshi bo.
We say let God bless everyone.
Ana mo le le ngwana.
Wherever you are,
mo direle.
Serve him.
Ska ba la bala tsho.
Don't worry.
No, ke na le le tshi.
He is the one that's looking.
Ye mo le ka moka.
All this condition.
Wa le monitor.
He is monitoring.
Motho a ska ba ba a kwa nka ba ru la thei.
Let no one feel like he's lost.
Ka ba ka la hore le fast
because this world
le na le lem.
It's got the condition.
Ke na na le re.
He is with us.
Morena vele.
May the Lord bless you.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.